This is the 2022 Toyota Tacoma. This truck has become known for its durability and resale value over the years, and is now equipped with a lot more fancy gadgets. The Tacoma has features like adaptive cruise control and pre-collision camera to help you get from point A to point B safely. With a backup camera as well as Apple CarPlay and Android Auto capabilities, this pickup combines plenty of luxury with its long-standing grit. The composite truck bed is still handy for all of your hauling needs, and the material lasts longer and withstands wear and tear much better than steel or other materials. Today, we're taking Brant Sherwood for a spin. The 6-foot center is in his second season with the Dogs, and the alternate captain has already notched 7 goals and 6 assists this season.
Brant.
Thanks for the ride, Mitch. Appreciate it, buddy.
How we doing, my man?
Doing good.
I'm Mitch Stewart, and this is Driving with the Dogs.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you for joining me. We'll let you get all strapped and buckled in here.
Yeah.
Wait, that's like
first
the first rule.
First things first. Yeah. Missed that one.
You've been with the team now for a while. I just wanted to know when Roanoke announced that they were canceling their season last year, what ended up bringing you back to the Dogs for another season?
I would say mostly the guys and Coach Dan. I like the way he runs his team here. And also the way we're treated here as well, the McGinns and all the owners, Swirlies, everyone up top does a great job taking care of us and giving us the tools to succeed and have a good time while we're here.
Now, you're from Rochester, New York originally. How was that experience like growing up for you and getting your start into hockey growing up in upstate New York?
So it was pretty easy. It's cold up there. We get a lot of lake effect snow. But it actually started with my sister, Ashley. She was a figure skater at her local rink. So my dad brought me out, watched her twirl around on the ice a couple times, and started crying and complaining a little bit that they shoved me out there as well. And I started pushing around the cart, and I got started pretty early skating, and then competitive hockey by like 6-7 years old.
There's now an unofficial SUNY fraternity among the Rail Yard Dogs. I think my last count is that 7 players on the active roster came from one of the SUNY schools. Is there, you know, any sort of little fun, friendly rivalries between you guys, maybe when some of the alma maters meet up, or is there kind of a running bit between you guys that, you
know? Honestly, there's no rivalry. We kind of just pump each other up, all the SUNYs. Like, I like to consider this place a little SUNY Roanoke. So, you know, we're all getting our master's degrees down here and, working on our SUNY education. What I think comes from the SUNY that translates well to the SP is we all got a little grit in us. We all played that hard-nosed, fast-paced game in the SUNY.
Has there been anything different since the start of the year where things were going maybe a bit slower than you wanted out of the gate, and then up until now where you finish off the month of December 7-1-2?
I think we were playing pretty good at the beginning of the year. It was those one-goal games where we were losing in shootouts and stuff like that. But, like, right now I think our time and like situation, what we do with the puck in certain spots during the game, like if it's late and we're up a couple, or we're protecting the puck, we're ragging time, stuff like that. So I think we're just better situationally.
It seems like everyone's kind of buying into Coach Primner's strategies, tactics, and he said the same things that you just said all year. Once you all had that first win, would turn around, and then they did, just as he predicted. You've played for head coach Dan Bremner now 2 seasons, or in your second season. What is it like playing under Coach Bremner? He seems like a pretty fiery guy down there on the bench.
Yeah, he's pretty fiery. He's got a lot of passion. But with Dan, we're the most, I would think we're the most prepared team from coaches I've had in previous years. We know what to expect from the other team. I think he does a great job of giving us the blueprint at the beginning of the week, working towards that, and then it's up to us to show up.
Are you a superstitious player yourself, and what are maybe some of your game day rituals that you like to stick to when you get to the arena?
So one thing I've always stuck with is getting dressed left to right. It's just something I do, and if I don't do it, it'll bother the hell out of me. So that's pretty much it for in the rink, I'm pretty random. One weird one recently is my girlfriend's been waking me up during my naps, and I get a little grumpy. And for some reason, I have a good game, and the team has a good game whenever I don't get my nap in. So I could be falling right asleep, and then whether it's my girlfriend opening the door or Tucker, my dog, having a squeaky toy, I end up not getting my sleep in, but I have a good game. So maybe no more naps.
You mentioned Tucker, and I do want to touch on Tucker a little bit because he's around the locker room some. He's, you know, he's only, what, a few months old now?
8 months, yep. He's still a pup.
What has it been like trying to kind of raise your own Tuck sauce off the ice?
Man, he kind of walks all over me, to be honest. He's a little too cute. He's very well potty trained, so we got a couple good things going for us. He's very well potty trained. He's a good walker, and he's super friendly. He doesn't have a mean bone in his body. We do need to work on the jumping on people. So that's in the practice plan for the past couple weeks. But right now he's out of commission and he got neutered. So he's on the IR for the next couple weeks, and he's going to be out of the locker room. And I know we'll give the guys a break, but I'm sure some of the guys will be missing him for
hey,
sure.
Hey, Tucker's just going around jumping on people being aggressive. He's just taking after his owner, huh?
Yeah, you're letting them know. You know, we got to be ready off the bat. Even if it's 7:45 in the morning, you got a coffee in your hand and spilling it all over the place. He's there for a smile, though, and I'm sure the guys appreciate it when he's around.
But how would you kind of gauge the overall mood and the overall confidence of the team right now around the locker room?
Right now, we are where we want to be, but we're not satisfied. We want to stay on top, and we want to be a winning team, and we want everyone to notice it. Like, I think Roanoke's kind of been in the middle of the pack for the past few years, and I think we just know it's the right time to take the next step and be one of those top organizations, because we owe it to the fans, we owe it to our owners, we owe it to Dan. More importantly, and to ourselves.
Is there anything that I haven't touched on or anything that's on your mind that you'd like to kind of have out there for RailYard Dogs fans to hear?
I just think the crowds have been awesome, and you guys are being super loud, and we notice it a ton during the games. Like, we hear the roar when we score, or there's a big fight like the last game. I think that is the loudest I've heard the building in a while when we beat up Huntsville there. We'll try to keep putting on a show and putting forth our best effort.
You know, hopefully we can keep this home winning streak going and keep it rolling on the ice.
Sure,
you guys
hope
have been
so.
Great.
Yeah, it's awesome. Thanks so much, Mitch. Man. Appreciate yeah. it.
Have a good rest of your day, and good luck this weekend, man.
Thanks. Have a good one.
You too.
You keep up the great work as well, Mitch.
Thanks, buddy.
Driving with the Dogs is sponsored by Haley Toyota, the official ride of your RailYard Dogs. Visit Haley Toyota online at HaleyHasItForLess.com and stay tuned for more episodes coming soon.